Thank you so much, sir. Back in this thing, Lounge Studios, New York, New York. Didn't even really want to. We're here with Mizz Toasty. King Nigel, what up?
Yo, what it do? What it do?
Ain't nothing. Back up in this thing, doing what we do, right?
I'm over here, you know, giving thanks, maintaining, striving, as usual. Peace, love, and light to one and all.
I know.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
If you're listening, ancestral guidance and protection, and one, you know, to you. Thanks for tuning. Yeah. Mizz Toasty, thank you for coming.
I don't think if anybody noticed, you probably did. I just restarted the song because I just like accidentally pressed it. It's okay. We're gonna keep rolling. It's just a pleasure to have you here, Mizz Toasty. I don't know where to begin taking this trip, taking the time out. We always want to say we appreciate all of our athletes that come and take the time out to visit us. We don't take it for granted. We're excited for your competition coming up in July. What is the name of this freestyle calisthenics competition?
It's called Empress of the Bars.
Okay. And why is it called Empress of the Bars?
Well, I am a very spiritual woman.
Okay.
And in the tarot, the Empress is the strongest, most dominant woman in the deck.
The where?
Tarot.
I understand what you're saying. Okay.
Yes. And okay. I feel that in the past year, I have grown into an empress.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. I also noticed, too, that when it comes to your brand and how you promote, you're very, very focused on the ladies, the women. Very feminine and in tune with how the women, I guess you say, produce on the bar, how they hold themselves to a certain standard. Why are you so focused on women? Even though, yes, you are a woman, but why is it really focused towards women?
I'm focused on women because we're so not focused on women. Mm. Since, I want to say, 1890, until we've finally gained rights, women are still fighting every day. And I am a Spanish woman, so I have been discriminated against a lot, almost my whole life. I'm also a small woman, so that comes to account as well. And I just feel, I just want to fight for women. I think that somebody needs to, and that there's so many women who have power and do nothing with it. And I don't have much power, but...
Oh, but you do?
maybe. I feel...
Just gotta wake it up. Yeah.
You know, I don't see the power, although I've been told. I just want to do the right thing. And like I said, nobody else is doing it. Mm. I feel like it's an opportunity. Why aren't we being marketed? Mm. You know, women are great to look at, number one.
Oh, yeah.
Oh
yes.
Right?
Yes.
We're enjoyable.
Absolutely.
We're beautiful.
Indeed. I hope so.
And with indeed. Movement, calisthenic movement added to it, I don't understand why it's so underrated or why we're not given as much opportunity. You know, I've been part of things, unfortunately, where I've been treated unfairly because I was a woman in the calisthenics world that is not as important as the men because it is dominantly men.
But you've done something about it and you are doing something about it. Speaking of which, although we are going to talk about this new competition coming up in July of 2023, let's speak about the one that just took place. Was it last year or the year
last
before?
Last year, yes.
Last year.
July 31st.
Go ahead, Nigel. Sorry.
Before you go on, I just want to say, don't feel bad because mostly the men do it for the women.
Maybe.
I mean, aside from self,
yeah.
You know, why else are we doing
it? He's not lying. He's
yeah.
not lying.
So don't feel no way.
If a man wears a t-shirt and a woman doesn't notice his biceps, he may get upset. But if a woman wears a t-shirt and they notice her bicep, she as well will be upset because women are worried and scared to be muscular, to be strong. Because we've always been told not to be, you know?
Do you think that's just a traditional mindset?
It's definitely a tradition. It's been going on forever. Women are supposed to cook and clean, and the men are supposed to do all the rough and tough stuff. And I don't think that's fair.
But what if the roles are reversed, and then the man is doing all the cooking and cleaning, and then the woman is doing
then
all the
rough? Then that's what should be done.
Okay, I love it. I love it.
How about that?
No doubt. I respect that.
In this day and age, I think it should be a balance.
It could be whatever you want
whatever
it to
is, whatever, as long as it gets done, right?
As long as people feel that they're treated fair and that they're loved in the right way, who cares how that relationship or role goes, you know?
I love it.
I think most of that is just propaganda. I mean, a lot of people buy into it, but it's just media hype, if you ask me.
Well, yeah.
At the end of the day, I think it's a woman's world.
I agree.
I don't know if James Brown would agree with that,
yeah,
sir.
It's a song, yeah. Well, listen to the song. It's a man's world, but it ain't nothing
without a woman. Yep.
Like I just said,
he knows what he's
talking about. For the most part, we do it for the women. We do it for the women.
No doubt. I can respect that 100%. I also respect
you. Aside from self.
Well, yeah. Yeah. I also respect you a whole lot for the hard work you put into your calisthenic events. Empress of the Bars, the first one last year. Let's talk about it a little bit. Some of the athletes that you felt like, first of all, who were some of the winners that came out of it? Do you remember off the top of your head?
So let me first mention my teammate.
Okay.
Love her. Her name is Julie. She also got the chance to be a part of WCO due to the impact of Empress of the Bars, which I try very hard to make sure we get every move and every photo. Just really want to put these women out there. There's a lot of talent that's not being shown because we're just repetitive with the same people. You see the same men in calisthenics at the top for a while now. Let's give somebody else a chance, you know? I feel that way about the women. There's a lot of women out there, but it's like everybody's focused on the same women. It's like, all right, like, what about these other women putting in the work, you know, that have all this talent? They deserve to be showcased as well.
Mm-hmm.
We had another great talent, Nay. She's
strongest DMV
reps girl I've ever seen. I wouldn't be going against her.
She is a straight-up monster. She's the kindest soul you ever meet.
And she's such a sweet, sweet girl. I love her. She's so great. I'll say that a lot about people. I have a big heart, and I love people. And these women, I care for all of them very much. And I just want to see them thrive. And I'll do everything I can to make sure that happens, including with myself.
Yes.
I do not forget me.
Yes, because you are an awesome competitor as well. Just from what I know, I could just see how you've continued to grow and build yourself and learn new moves, new sins, new sessions, all of that type. Even when you're by yourself, sometimes I see that you don't even need a crowd around you. You just go out there and you do it. What drives you to get better?
What's your motivation?
It's not something good, I guess.
Why you say that?
Well, this is not an answer I don't think you would get from most people, but it is honest. I thrive more alone because I am an alone person. I am not very close with family. I do have many associates, but I'm very strict with whom I am close.
Share your energy.
Very friendly. Like,
I understand. I'm the
same
way.
I guess more like I would say my friends are like family, and it's a very small crowd. Although I love people.
Yes.
And I love being around them. I also love to be away from them.
Yo, I love that.
Me too.
I love that, and I understand that. Because you need time to recuperate, recharge, regenerate mentally and emotionally. And physically too, you know?
Being alone can be a very powerful thing.
Yes.
And as I was saying, the reason I thrive and have so much self-motivation is because I never really had parents who were patting me on the back, like, good job.
Right.
If anything, my parents were like, you could do better, do more. You know, that's just their way.
Tough love. You think that was tough love?
I don't
love?
Know if it's tough love. I think that's just love, and we've named it tough, you know.
Say that again.
I think that it's just love, and we named it Tough. Yeah, I think love comes in a lot of forms.
Many different expressions.
And I don't think if they were not this way with me that I would thrive as much, because then I would have like a codependency or a need. So I also went through something last year where I was probably at my loneliest, and calisthenics was my friend.
We would have never known. And that's the great thing about it, that you had something to release all of that pressure and, I would say, bad energy. You know, you were able to release that on the bar. I think a lot of calisthenic athletes are the same way. We have some type of traumas that we try to navigate through.
Pain to power.
There you go. What started you in freestyle calisthenics? I'm going to let you answer that, and I'm going to step out real quick. Nigel, you can hold it down for a second.
I'm going to try to.
You got it. You got it.
Can you do it?
Go for it.
So what got me started, you're saying?
Yes, tell the people.
Well, I don't like to mention my past too much, but there was a special someone that I was with, and he introduced me to calisthenics in 2016. But I didn't really start it until I met many other people in the community and I started to see all of this amazing energy and how people were cheering each other on. And I don't know, I never had a sense of community. Mm-hmm. Even though I grew up in New York and there's a lot of people here, it could be very lonely. It's easy to be lonely here. I mean, not that lonely is a bad thing. I enjoy to be lonely.
I think they want you to be lonely here.
Right?
Oh,
I'm so lonely.
I know. I'm so lonely. Yeah, that's a song.
But you can thrive alone.
Yeah, absolutely.
People always say the opposite. I hear it often. They're like, oh, how could you be alone, alone, alone? And for me, like, sometimes it's better. I could focus more. I don't have anybody else telling me what I should or shouldn't do. You know, I know a lot of people when they practice and train together, everybody's just trying to help each other out. But sometimes it's just like, I'm a very controlling person. And I'm going to do it my way. You know, and I just could focus more when I'm alone. I don't know. Maybe I'm just different than everyone else. I don't need anyone.
Motivation.
Yeah. That's the role for a lot of leaders.
That's how I go about it. It's a lonely road for leaders.
Yes, as absolutely. Sip my rosé.
Absolutely.
Especially when it comes to working out.
No, seriously. I think working out, and I don't know if you agree, Mizz Toasty, it has to be something. It has to be more than just motivation from other people. It has to be in you, something you have to cultivate, like a garden, I would say. And if you don't cultivate it, you can lose it.
Yeah.
You know, you have to be dedicated to the craft.
Oh, yes.
To excel, especially in freestyle calisthenics. What is something that you do to continually keep yourself at a high level, not only as a leader in the community, but also as an event planner?
Well, what do? I want to say that every day is almost a struggle. Mm. It's not easy. I would say most of the time, I don't want to, you know. But then there's someone or something inside me saying, you gotta do it. Mm-hmm. You have to. You want to be a champion? This is what you have to do, you know. And I thrive on that. Like, just having to force it. You know, it's not easy. You know, when I feel like I'm misplaced, I'm very organized, so I just make a list. This is what I'm doing on my workout. You know, and I'll have a set plan. And what is my goal? And I make short-term goals. A lot of people, they want to try all the new moves, but they have not mastered a skill yet. I like to try the new move. If I get it and I accomplish it, I will do it in, out, backwards, forwards, and master it to a point where I could do it with my eyes closed, you know? I wish I could, but you get my drift.
Absolutely.
And then I'll move on to something else. And I just break things down. And, you know, there are days where, you know, I'm tired or, you know, as I said, I am alone. I don't have someone else saying, you know, Toasty, get off your ass. You know, you got to go work out. You know, but I just make sure. I make sure I wake up. If I don't do it in the morning, I do it after work. I don't make any excuses. And anytime I feel that I am making excuses, I get my ass out the house. Like, I force it, to be honest.
Oh my gosh. You said something right there, and I totally agree with you. So your point about being lonely, loneliness is not exclusive. You don't have to be, you can have a huge family and still be a lonely person, especially here in New York City. You can be anywhere. You sit, no, seriously.
Especially
you spoke to making yourself get up and go. Forcing yourself to get up and go. I was going to ask, speak to the lonely people out there that are in calisthenics. They can't voice it, or they don't even feel comfortable enough to voice that, man, I need somebody. I need to be around good people. It's hard for me.
Sucks to need, doesn't it?
I think we all do, though, as humans, no? I think all humans are connected. We just feel like sometimes in our ego and arrogance that we can make it alone.
And I never felt like I needed anything.
But don't you?
From anyone.
You do, don't you? To a point. Mizz Toasty,
what do I need, though? Energy. That I cannot give myself.
Well, you don't really need anything. I agree with you, but
I don't feel like I needed anybody. I never felt like I needed someone. I always felt like I wanted it. Mm. It was something that would be nice to have. But if I didn't have it, I wasn't feeling lack.
Everything you need is already in you.
I feel very whole in my own, and that's why I don't need anyone. Or that's why I choose. Like, me being lonely is a choice I make. It's not because if it was up to my friends and my family, I would be with people every day on top of training and work. You know, what I do for work is very sociable, too. I'm constantly around people. If anything, I crave for the loneliness, for the quiet. You know, I have a dog at home. I just want to be with him and nobody else.
Right now?
For right now, yeah. For right now, not forever. Yes. Nobody wants to be alone forever. If I am and that is my life, then I'm okay. That was my destiny.
You built for it.
I can do it, yes.
I love your energy.
You get more accomplished, too, depending on
I am way more accomplished when I'm alone, too. Total focus on yourself.
Do you think that has allowed you to build a brand such as Empress On The Bars and literally put that together? Because it's no easy feat to put a calisthenic event together. Do you think that's something that fueled you, being alone and being able to focus and lock in? Or do you have a lot of help with that?
First, I want to say, yes, I do have help, not as much as I'd like. But there are certain people who have stuck with me since the first one. Very small few, not a lot, but I do everything on my own. In that sense, there is no help. You know, yes. I scout, I organize, I've created rules, regulations, the look, the sound, the way things are promoted. Everything I do, CEO, 100%, creator, I am the inventor,
the bomb.
You know, educator, and I organize for sure.
Yes. Okay, sticking with that same Empress of the Bars mindset, going into this next one in July, what should we expect as not only athletes, but as spectators? Because the first one was phenomenal. I would never know. How hard? Well, I knew just being in the culture how hard it is, but on the outside looking in, I would never know how hard it is.
Yeah, there's so much.
It was amazing. Mm-hmm. Talk to us. What are we looking for to this next one? July, when is it?
July 30th.
July 30th.
On
Empress
a Sunday.
Of the Bars 2?
Yes, Empress of the Bars 2. Well, we're not calling it that.
Okay.
You know, I didn't want to put a number in there. I just want to let it be what it is. And hope that the numbers will just keep going, you know. I don't want to put a stop to it. I want it to be forever.
No doubt.
And what you'll expect is new faces.
New faces from the first one?
Old faces.
So tell us some new athletes that you may have on deck, some that are really... And where are they coming from? Because I know they come from all over.
One girl, Sheila. She is amazing. Great dynamic. Super strong. She's really tall and bubbly and sweet. I got to meet her this couple months ago in January from the last comp that I did, and I won.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Lots of hard work for that win, let me tell you. Of course, we'll have Julie. I will always make sure to have my teammates. It's very important to, since I made my team from the very beginning, I told them that I'm going to do everything I can to bring them up with me. You know, all of them will get their chance to, Julie never competed before until Empress of the Bars. And just with one event, she's already, boom, everybody knows Julie. And I'm like, oh, it warms my heart.
Yes.
Because, you know, if we're not helping each other, like, how are we going to get anywhere, you know? Everybody's so busy stepping on each other, pushing each other out the way.
You see it, right?
You can get more things done when you have, you know, more care and kindness.
And kindness. Yep. Absolutely. Well, I also, well,
Mr. Stronger than a finger. Right.
We also have Maya coming from Chile.
Woo,
she's just won last year's, the one I just did this past month, which was amazing. Did you see it?
Which one?
My last competition in Brazil. South America, yeah.
Huh. Well, it was my first one too, so I was still kind of getting to know everyone. And all the ladies, I was just blown away.
We had
by
a lot
skill.
Of women.
Yeah,
I was very happy
level.
To see this.
Yes,
I think there was like, 12 of us, and then I made the finals, and then I think they only had two more after that. Fortunately, I did not take home the win, but you know, I learned that through the only way you're ever gonna win is if you fail. Like, there's no way to escape it. Mm-hmm. Some people are lucky. And their grass is greener, but you have to pay attention to your grass.
Yes.
You know, and not worry about other people. I do see people who have way easier in calisthenics than me, mm-hmm. you know? And I'm just like, good for you, you know? Do something for other people. If you're that blessed, why you don't help anybody? Mm-hmm. You know, maybe I will change this. I hope that is like what I'm thriving for, that women will be more loving, that we'll get more experienced girls out here, you know. I want to bring as many women as I can to New York, let them showcase their show out, you know, their skills. Mm-hmm. I don't want to say any more people.
No, say no more. Understood.
I'll give those two.
Yeah, let them cook. Yes. You have a signature move too on the bar, it seems to me. Am I correct?
That backbend.
Yeah, man. Where did you discover that?
It's a backbend into an eagle grip catch, and it's blind. So,
blind meaning,
you know,
to people who are layman's.
Blind
term.
As in
you can't
I
see.
Throw myself and hope to catch. You know? That's blind. Honestly, when I first started calisthenics, I could not do much. I could not pull up or push up or muscle up. I was very weak. You know, I started zero. That's another thing. Everybody. Doesn't matter what level you are. Who cares if you just work every single day on that same goddamn thing? Ooh, can I curse?
No, go for it.
If you just work every day, no matter how many times you fail, if you just do it, keep doing it.
Consistency.
Just keep doing it. I cannot stress this.
Consistency.
Took me 8 months to get shrimp, okay?
What's a shrimp?
The shrimp catch I do. You flip backwards and you catch. So yeah, I have to go through my legs and blindly catch in front of me. It took me 8 months. I failed over and over and over. And every time I fell, I would just say, I'm gonna get it. This is the one. This is the one. Every time. And it was the one, eventually. Mm-hmm. And every move that I've accomplished, I've made sure to drill once I got it so I can keep it.
So what's the ratio now?
What do you mean?
Like, if you want to try that.
If I tried a shrimp right now, I get it right now. First try.
That sounds like, how many times, you can count how many times you fail?
I mean, 8 months of fails. Has to be in the hundreds. I would do at least 20 to 30 of them in one session.
Really?
Oh, yeah. I'm an animal. When I don't get something that I want, I will be fiercely savage-like until I get it.
I've seen you post about being fierce and
going
and getting it. So yeah, that's definitely necessary. What's that movie? One of the Batmans when the butler said, "Why do you fall down, Mr. Wayne? So you can get up." Simple as that, you know? We get up. So every time. And I've noticed that with freestyle calisthenic athletes, you guys are not afraid to fall.
I have a strong mind.
Yeah, yeah. And that's why I marvel at it. Even with the reps and sets, that's cool. And that takes a lot of endurance and mental capacity as well. But like you say, with the shrimp and all these moves you do where you have to just leave it and let go.
Leave it to fate. Leave it to fate. You know what? Also, you have to trust that you did the work to get here. No matter what it is you're doing in your life, whether it's calisthenics or music or being a painter. You know, people say to me, why don't you get nervous during comps? And I just say, I trust my work. I did all of the work I could do. Now, you have no control at this point. You have to leave it to fate. If you just go with what you feel, trust that work, there's no reason to be nervous. Mm. Your skill is still your skill, right? You do something long enough, eventually it becomes second nature, you know? And that's why I take my time with things as well. Very important, I think, if you want to be a master at something, you have to take it slow, be patient, fail a lot, don't worry about it. Not at all.
Really? Just why do like I that. Feel so comforted right now? I feel encouraged now. No, that's real. So,
do you also personal train?
I do, yes. Okay. I do sessions with groups. I do all female sessions sometimes as well. I do like handstand shops. But I also have my other business, so I am like 50-50, you know? Also, I have to find time to train for me because I'm trying to be a champion. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm not trying.
I am a champion.
You know, it's hard to... It's just that when you work so hard for something and then it happens, you're just like... You, like, knew it would, but it's like you went through all of these things... And it's almost unbelievable sometimes.
It is.
You're just fighting to get there for so long. Yeah, and I forget sometimes.
To take
appreciate myself, what I'm doing, all this. You know, I'm so focused on everybody else and helping other people, which takes nothing from me. I love it. I like to help others. But I forget to think about, oh, yeah, that's right. I did some stuff.
Yeah, you did some. And that's what we want people to understand, too, that I think ones that are not in a culture or community, they don't understand what it takes, the hard work it takes. They see a few reels on Instagram, a couple seconds, and they keep scrolling.
Right.
But they don't know what happened there. Into everything that you do. What's next for Mizz Toasty? You have Empress of the Bars coming up in July. Do you plan on taking this nationally, maybe worldwide?
Well,
because New York, you got it on lock already.
I am planning on moving it elsewhere. Not sure if that will be next year or maybe the year after. It will depend on lots of things. Where I am, if I'm still living where I'm living. You know... I cannot say I'm planning ahead that far.
Yes.
Right now, my focus is on the event next month. I have something coming.
Yes.
For myself.
Don't say. Leave it.
But
leave
I'm
it,
not. I'm not going to say anything. Okay. You know, it's going to be a little bit from now, but really big. Really excited for that. I do have some things in the work. I cannot say.
I understand. The main thing is for me, Mizz Toasty, and again, I appreciate you for coming, taking the time out to explain what it takes as a woman to put an event together, to have multiple women to come and compete at the highest level. Not only just freestyles, by the way, you also have reps and sets and reps there. Is it going to be there as well?
Always. You know, I do that because I feel like the reps and sets community doesn't get enough shine either. I'm here to break down for women.
Okay.
Yeah, there's always just like one or two, maybe three. Like I've never really seen actually more than two competing females. Mm-hmm.
There's like two or three that continually.
Yeah, it's like the same people.
I know why.
Because.
Well, I know to a degree, but
nobody's giving the opportunity to the less than. Because if you're just this much less than, you're not good enough. But that's to everybody else. That's not to me. I see people differently, especially the women I have in my competitions. I look for them. I pick them. I single them out. I'm looking for something specific, particular. Also, I look for women who have no shine, you know, new faces.
Yes.
People
diamonds in the rough.
Those people are praying, please, somebody recognize me. Give me a chance.
And they go on hard.
And I could hear them, and I come. And that's the way I go.
That's so fire. That's so fire. Anything, Nod, you got anything else on your mind? Because we packed a lot here really quickly. We're not going to keep Mizz Toasty all night because she has a little bit of a travel. But that's all I really have, Mizz Toasty. Thank you for coming.
Thank hanging
out with
me.
Us. You're going to hear
much
more.
Much success.
Yeah, with Miss Epic.
I'm going to try to get involved. No.
No, seriously. We're going to pull up July as usual. Support the ladies, you know.
Yeah, you got to support the men. Need to support the women.
Absolutely. And where is this competition going to be at?
It's going to be at the Brooklyn Zoo.
The Brooklyn Zoo.
230 Bogart Street.
There we go.
Brooklyn, New York.
And, yeah, Brooklyn, New York. That is correct.
Oh, yeah.
So I plan to be there, Ja willing. Naji, we think you might pull up.
I'm going to try to.
Possibly.
What is that, a weekend?
Sunday?
It's on a Sunday.
Oh. We'll see what happens. I'll be there. Miss Sosie, thank you for coming. Sunday. Representing Empress of the Bars.
Most likely not.
Mizbarfit. Yes?
Is that yes, that's... Okay, so Mizbarfit is my team, which I made into a company. And the name of the event is Empress of the Bars.
Got it.
My name is Mizz Toasty.
There you go. Thanks for coming. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in to this particular episode for Mizz Toasty. And we are going to shut this down with a cool-down song. This is Wally Lopez, Deep Drive. I think this might be a vibe. Picture yourself at a competition. Mizz Toasty is coming up to the bar. She's about to get it going. Throw it. Send it. Everything. All right? Thank you for coming, Mizz Toasty. We appreciate you. Cody, you can shut off the mics, please. Peace.